Actually, I wasn't going to make a testimony today, but I was persuaded to do so because Laos is so unknown. Actually, I'm able to make the testimony here because I'm married to a Lao, but I'm not a Lao national. And so I want to let everybody know the situation. On 15 December 2012, nearly 10 months ago, my husband, Sumbat Sumpon, was taken away right in front of a police post on a busy thoroughfare in the capital city of Laos. His abduction was caught on camera installed by the public security, purportedly to help improve the security of the city and to deter crimes. Footages from the closed-circuit TV showed that my husband was stopped by the police, made to get out of his vehicle, taken into the police post. A few minutes later, a man dressed in black drove away his vehicle, and then a white truck took him away. That was the last time I ever saw him. The official Lao government statement said that the police only stopped Sumbat for routine checks of vehicle documents, and after that, they do not know what had happened to him or who had taken him away. The government promised to investigate, but 10 months later, the investigation had turned up nothing. They did not find Sumbat's vehicle, they did not identify the person who drove it away, and they did not identify the owner of the truck and the people who took Sumbat away. Laos is a one-party communist state where there are very efficient and comprehensive public security networks and surveillance systems that extend down to every village. These systems can track the comings and goings of every individual. Criminal activities are limited, and crimes are quickly solved if the authorities wanted to. But the Lao government official statement repeatedly said that the police have done everything they can to find Sumbat, but to no avail. But who is Sumbat Sumpon, and why did he disappear? Sumbat is an ordinary Lao citizen from a poor farming family. He spent the last 30 years working on sustainable rural development, education, and youth empowerment to improve the livelihoods of the poor and expand the space for civil society engagement. His work on community empowerment had won him recognition both inside and outside the country. He even won the Magsaysay Award in 2005, the Asian equivalent of the Nobel Prize. Sumbat's last public role prior to his abduction was to support the organization of the Asia-Europe People's Forum in Vientiane. I suspect that it is Sumbat's role in organizing such a major civil society forum in Laos that provoked the conservative elements of the state security apparatus to abduct Sumbat and to silence the emerging voice of civil society in Laos. On the surface, Laos is a country that respects human rights. Laos has acceded to almost all the international human rights conventions, has also established legal systems that purportedly uphold the rule of law and protect the life and liberty of its citizens. Laos is also a signatory to the UN Convention of Enforced Disappearance. But however, inside Laos, the government rules Laos with an iron fist, and there's no room for debate on government policies. Space for civil society action is limited, and the media is tightly controlled, as we have heard in so many of the countries whose representatives are here in this room. Hence, there's little public awareness or even recognition by the citizens that enforced disappearance is a human rights issue. Sumbat disappearance is not the only one such case. There are many cases of disappearances in Laos, but little was ever published. This is because the family members and the victims are too afraid to speak out or to reach out. Recently, I tried to reach out to another wife whose husband was also abducted, but I was told that the person wants to remain confidential and does not want to reach out because she's still afraid. I can understand that the citizens of Laos are afraid and they are fearful, but what I cannot understand is that the silence is also echoed by international development agencies that work in the country, including the UN, the international NGOs, and many of the countries that provide assistance to Laos. Statements of concerns have been aired. The government has been politely asked what has happened to Sumbat, and they were told the same story I was told, and they accepted. But there has been no public condemnation. As long as the government does not suffer any consequences for their action, I believe they will do nothing. We heard in the last 2 days that most of these countries, most of the countries that have very repressive governments, provide a very human face. I believe they accede to all these international conventions because they want the assistance to flow. So I think we should make those international conventions and make those agreements carry teeth. Without that teeth, nothing will happen to human rights abuses. And we will continue to hear in similar platforms the litany of abuses that we have heard over the last 2 days. So I want to thank you all. I particularly want to thank the frontline defenders for giving me this opportunity to speak to you. Thank you.